Ideally, like, all three of these guys don't have Aegis. Which they hold on, so that's good. So Robin can go over there and deal with that. I could deal with you early if I want, because you don't have any scary skills right now. This guy has counter. Oh, this guy's annoying. This guy's cover the same spaces, right? Yeah. Do you guys not cover anything that this guy covers? Not other than, I mean, well, I guess. Nah. I mean, unless I want to go here, but no. So I'm gonna go here with Robin. Question is how do I mean, I could take this guy early. How strong is Chrom? He gets plus 3 strength from Pan. 25, 28, 22. Okay, so he one shots this, that's good. I can go for that in turn 1, it's fine. And the question is do I want to. Like, do I want to do a little bit of damage to this guy with Cordelia and. Well, mostly Cordelia. It's gonna barely deal any damage. And she doesn't have, like, the best dress. I could do it with you, but. Like, that's, like, a way I can start getting Cordelia and all together. The damage I do to this doesn't really accomplish that much, though. I feel like. Hard to say. 1-6 damage models. Oh, that's a little bit 1-6. No, it's 6. Okay. But like, it's fine. I can't take this, really. I'm just gonna have like. Okay, I'm gonna just try this. I don't know if I should pair up Sumia and Robin or not. I'm gonna try doing so, but I'm not convinced that it's good. It said it does give some XP to Sumia and she desperately needs that, so. Do I even want Callum? Probably still, yes, I don't know. Okay, what's your speed thing? Okay, you double everything other than these. I mean, I can't double this. That's a good speed to be at. Hey, my Miriel is very fast. My Miriel is insanely fast. Wait. How does she have 18 speed at level 12? Yeah, Miriel starts with 7 speed, and I've literally gotten speed every single time on her. That's crazy. That's insane. Ah, I should do more. I think he has 60 speed growth, if I remember correctly. Yeah. So getting all 11 speed ups is 0.3%. Well, 0.36%. It's crazy. That's so good. How's her magic compared to what it should be? What's it start with? Like 6 plus 2 or something? I'm not sure what she starts with. There we are. 6 plus 2, I was right. So she's gotten 8 over 11, that's also above average. Expected to get 6.6 over 11. So yeah, my Miriel is very good. It is very, very good. That's what I said last time, when you compare these two, like, my Miriel looks insanely strong. So it's like, cause my Miriel got insane level ups. Like, look how well she compares to Robin. Yes, just 2 less speed, 2 less defense, 5 less res, and 7 less magic. And 7 less HP. It's so good for Miriel. Okay, anyway. You're gonna be over on this side. Or something like this. Wait, okay. Why do I need to bring Gaius? She doesn't need speed support at all for this. So she actually would rather have, like... I mean, she doesn't really need any support, right? Well, Gaius gets movement. That's probably just work, like, good enough. Sure. Don't want to be in your range, right? No, actually I do. Oh, that's good. I didn't realize that I could do that. Even though I think that's actually my Muriel's threat to do that. You can also reach me there, right? Yeah. Okay, yeah, this is good. I should have checked that that kills these. Okay, it does. What's this kill? 24? 18? Nope. 18, 19? No. So not. It's not even 19, it's just 18. Okay, we got like a couple dual strikes with Donald there. Or, like, ideally, I could just get a miss. I just get a dodge, rather. And get a dual strike with Donald, that would be great. I kind of like expect that to happen, obviously, but you know. It would be cool if it did. Let's see what happens. Oh, wait, I have to move you guys. That's a good miss. Come on, Sumia. Damn it. I really want Sumia to attack so that she gets a little bit of XP. Mostly XP, the weapon rank doesn't matter that much. That's a good miss. Oh, come on, Donald. Nice, that's good. Also a good miss. Fortunately, Sumia not getting any attacks. Oh, my defense is a lot worse than I thought it was. I would have died if the Luna guy hit me. Yeah, I definitely need to switch back to having Kalam support later. What's that? That guy did 21 damage to me. Yeah, my Robin's defense is not great. I wonder where it should be right now. I'd have to check when I second sealed him though. I don't want to do that right now. Well, the interesting part is how am I gonna deal with this guy. This deals 14 and he heals 6. Unfortunately, I positioned you in a way where you can't reach anything. It might not have been the optimal play. That said, I can get in your range, although you have Aegis, which is annoying. I should have... remove the wind instead of the steel lance so that she could use the steel lance. That was bad. I was like thinking that, like, oh yeah, the steel lance would be good for Sumia right now, but then I didn't make the connection to actually just like put back the wind, like the forge wind or the thunder or the forge wind. So this guy is the big issue, and then this guy is like the less big issue. Let's say I deal 14 to you. 14 plus 15 is not enough. And that would still not be enough. No, wait. Yeah. Somewhat unfortunate. I can't give her magic. So I'd have to give her more strength, which is sort of hard to do. What should I go with that line? Oh, you don't have a javelin. Hmm. Okay, it's slightly awkward. Ah, you don't know. No. So giving her strength support would be pretty hard. So there is some merit to buying a magic tonic for her so that these two together can kill this, but it's not super important. This guy might be staying alive this turn. What I might end up doing is, oh wait, the positioning here is weird, right? Because this block's the only spot where she could gain support from. Oh, that's bad. What's this? Is, I mean, yeah, this doesn't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hit enter, yeah. Wait, no, I'm done. I could just pair up here, make this attack, transfer an attack, and kill this. So that works. Well, I'm trying to flee with Kadam instead of Merrick. Not super happy with that play, but I don't really see something else. Anything else? Not a wing that guy. Yeah, I don't really see anything else. So the question is, do I want to risk with Kalam or with Fred? Probably with Kalam. I don't have Kalam available as a mod. This would be 2 more damage than this, so 17, so 16 is enough. Cool, that's good, actually, because now I get to do this. That's better, it's a lot better. First of all, I get to use the javelin over the steel lance, which is good because this guy will attack her so long as I get these two out of the way. Which I might actually not be able to. I can go this way. The thing is, do I even want to bother with that though? Like, do I not just want to put somebody here, get attacked, and live with it? Instead of moving everybody all the way there? That's probably just worse. You can, like, almost kill with her support. He could if he had a steel lance. Which. I could give him actually. I would go here, I could take the steel lance out of the convoy, give it to Gaius. Gaius moves here, and then I could kill him that way. That may be worth. So let's do this. Just to make sure we don't miss, I guess. Okay, good strength, should not get speed, unfortunately. But I can't complain about an HP strength defense level up as the first level up on her. She currently needs strength more than speed. In the late game. So, like, for right now, speed. Strength matters more. But for late game purposes, I want her to have gotten a lot of speed. So, like, ideally, she gets a bunch of strength early, and then at some point starts transitioning into getting more speed. Okay, so I think I'm going to do this play that I said. Wait, let me just check this. Yeah, it's plus 3, yeah. Surely. Yes, that's. So I trade. I mean, well, convoy first. So this, I guess. I should really have this with me, by the way. Well, maybe. Oh fuck, I'm fucking retarded. This guy has no Nosferatu. Whoops. I'm an idiot. Making this attack might still be correct. Because there's. Okay. Gaius, how strong are you? 12, it's for 6. That is not as much as he heals. It's for 7. So I can dodge. Or I could have Gaius make 2 dual strikes. Or it's like slightly unfavored that I kill. Fucking dumb, dude. Should pay attention to that, obviously. Like, he doesn't die regardless, because like, I get to 15 and next time I get to 15 again, it's fine. But I think I just need to, I think I just want to actually. This guy is so hard to deal damage to, I think I just want to make this attack anyway. Okay, well, I got lucky. Now, I want to stay out of range of you, but in range of you. So I go here. I mean, I can't really get into anybody else's range, I guess. No. We have Aegis. Do. Okay. Take some damages. 15. 9. So if I wanted one to kill, I'd have to deal 27 damage to it, which means I'd have to deal 28 damage to it. So I'd have to hit for 34. Yeah, they can't do that.
If I get two dual strikes, then that's 18 damage. I have to deal another 18 damage, so I want to hit for 24. I do that anyway, so I don't have to switch weapon.
Sure, how much my one hour stand should be where. Don't know. Getting a lot of lucky misses. I definitely think I'm being lucky on like dodges, but I also think that I'm not so lucky on the skills that I rolled. Not like absurdly unlucky or anything, just like not. I think it's definitely on like the more unlucky part. Like these guys both having corner ages, when I have to deal with these before I really get to deal with this side. For example. And this guy over here also having Aegis Pavis, which is one of Nosferatu guy like really annoying. That said, like, it's definitely not absurd or anything. And I'm getting lucky on the dodges to make up for it. So... it's a bit weird. She dual struck at some point. Would you keep playing? Okay, let's see. How much damage should these three guys deal together to me? 0, 3, and then this guy does 5. This guy does better, deals 29 damage. Nope, 28 damage. So I live on 1, right? It's 24 plus 4, it's 28. 28, this doesn't have Luna, this doesn't have Luna. 28 plus 3 is 31. So 11-1, so that's good. So I get to stand in this position where Navi is standing. Where Navi is standing. The question is, I don't have to take this guy with Robin. This, like, I can totally take this guy with Miriel. It's like total. That's like entirely fine. We need to get the fuck over here, Crumb. So yeah, I think this guy I'm gonna take with probably Miriel. Maybe just you. This deals 16 to you. 2% crit rounds. So I have to stand next to two people. It's a bit annoying. Who has more res? You or Miriel? Miriel. It's good, I guess. Because that should mean that he should prefer attacking her. Mm-hmm. How about you? You die to this, so... It's not... It's pretty beneficial to take him with you. I really fucking hope that I get some dual strikes. Like, the chance is 47%, but I haven't gotten a single one yet. Like, I've gotten one, but I haven't missed. Oh, quite a few attacks. I can actually... Hold up. I mean, not really. I was gonna say I can actually just do this attack, but I don't think I can. Because I take too much damage. Like, this deals 15, then I take 15 again, and also this guy attacked me. Yeah. He doesn't have a great rest, despite being a Pegasus Knight. This is the kind of thing I always have to get used to every time I play Awakening again. That Cordelia's rest, is not that good. Like, it's on the good side, like, if you compare it to, like, Chrom's doing. But... It's not... Not really, she can't really take magic hits, actually. Sumia's rest is pretty decent, though. So I go here... what am I doing with you? The question... I should ask myself whether I want to risk this 1% crit chance. Well, slightly higher than 1%. 1.4%, I think. Because, like, if I... Let's send here instead. This blocks the way better. Right? I mean, not really. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. Also, you can still go there. Blocks the way for you, but I don't wanna block the way for you. Because he doesn't kill that, right? Yeah, like, he heals for 6 before I get to deal the 18. But after either he misses or I get a Donald rule strike, like, I'd be favored to kill that guy, but I don't really want to rely on that. So it would be better for XP than to just take that. Like, the issue is, I don't want to get attacked by both of these. So, I have to stand, like, all the way the fuck back here, which is, like, kind of annoying. I don't really want to stand all the way the fuck back here. Like, it's just makes it harder to deal with these guys next, like, coming up. Like, I want to start, like, I usually want to start engaging them, like, around in this area, and then, like, slowly back off as I finish them off. But if I go here, I, like, risk maybe just dragging the fire too far back, and then running into the map edge, and just kind of getting fucked. Probably I put, it's probably, okay, so where am I going? So Robin's going here. So probably I would put, there. You can you reach it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you definitely can, never mind. It is plain. I thought this was like, shit. Because I have to be on this edge. And these guys have to like go quite a far way this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like, these spaces are attackable. Yeah. These spaces are attackable. By that one. So I can either, like, I can. If I just want to take this hit, I can go on this side. And I can have some people, like, over there, but then they have to walk over the desert. Like, there's a lot of deserts here. Like, if I had somebody here, then in order to get to the plane, they'd have to go to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. Which, like, is all their movement for next turn. Which is pretty rough. I mean, she can do that fine. Like, I can totally, like, I can put... I can put like Cordelia here, or even here, maybe. I can put, no, it could be here, and then I would put Miriel here or here. And then I guess I can put Frederick here, and it's like, okay. Well, I would put Gaius here, and I would put Frederick up there, but, I mean, similar thing. And then Chrome can, like, start moving in this direction. You have to go this way? Well, you have to go, like, no, you have to go this way. Okay. I'm gonna go to the bathroom really quick, and then I'm gonna make that move that I just said. So the player said, as well, I have to get these guys out so I can see better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I'll probably put you here. You here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We go here. Javelin out. Doesn't matter what weapon you have equipped, but I'm just gonna die on you for now. You go here. Make sure I want to do it. What's more relevant here? 8 HP is separating. HP, right? Probably. Just that person didn't die by doing this play. Was it control zero, yeah? Well, that way we definitely don't die. Thank you. Thank you, Sumia. Sweet. Continue to get speed, but not magic on my plasmatic Robin. Yeah, because like now they can start going all the way, which is very scary. And because I don't have rescues, I don't even get to consider the play where I just kill this and then I rescue out. Because this guy will just gank me. Well, I mean. Yeah, could still. It's still possible that as a player, it starts with killing this. Absolutely. But it just. It's gonna be a little more intricate. If that is a play that I can make. So you are relatively easy to take. Without. I can easily take isolatedly. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, he just goes there and just say, put somebody here and it's fine. And he's not like super strong or anything either. Right, okay, so this side is definitely safe. This guy's actually a little bit annoying. It's hard to set up a way to not get crit. Mark Thunders, man. And God, this guy doesn't have Anathema. That would be so on roof. I don't like that enemies get to have Anathema. Anyway, more Anathema and Gamble, I suppose. That's not make it harder than it has to be. Make it harder than it has to be. Yeah, this is a bit weird. I really want to kill this, but it's hard. Love this guy. So what I could do... No, I could not. That said, like... Just like these two attacks together, do a lot of damage. That's 18, and then that's three less than 18, that's 15. 33 damage. So, I'd have to also give him defense. So, a play I can make potentially for killing this turn is I can go here. Luna goes out of Luna, right? Yeah. I can go here, I can kill this. Then she can fly over here. I can transfer Donal over. So that he gets defense. And then I can take a vulnerary so that I lift this hit. And because I get speed support, I still don't get doubled. He would attack her then. And then this guy would attack him. That's the only one who reaches. Now, so let's say I make this part of the play. How am I killing this? I took some damage just then. What do you get? 15? What luck do you have? I have okay luck. Doesn't kill her. 6, you need, yeah, I need a lot of speed to double that.
I look like a bad enough.
Just like, it has a crit rate, and I don't want to die to that. But it's hard to... I mean... From where can you go? Fuck. So what I could do... Ah, oh, wait, how fast are you? You double Chrom, that's not good. Okay, well, what I could do, actually... I could go here with Chrom. And put Chrom to Frederick. Then I could put Chrom to Gaius, and then I can put, then I can attack with Chrom there. That kills that, and if I were to make the play where I kill this, then the only body who can attack him is him. He doesn't kill Chrom, so that would be pretty okay. Not necessarily my favorite EXP distribution for this turn, but like... Man, you like barely live this attack, don't you? I think it's just a play though, right? This guy never attacks Chrom because Chrom has more health. I have more defense though. So he will always attack Cordelia. In some sense, it's unfortunate. I don't have to make the Chrom attack. I could risk the 1% crit. How much better is XP for Miriel than XP for Chrom though? Like, not much. If at all. I would like to have the XP on Cordelia, Donald, or Sumia instead, but I'm just not gonna get to. I think the only way I really see is this Roman that I said. Killed it. It's so bad though. It's like really not. I hate this play. How much defense do you have? You have 14 defense. But then they would just attack. Well then, I'd rather have them attack. If this guy attack, but then I have Roman though.
So what next I'm gonna be like, this guy's gonna be dead, this guy's gonna be slightly damaged, this guy's gonna be right up in Robin's face, Robin's gonna be almost dead, and these guys are gonna be up here. It's just not a good situation to be in next turn. Maybe I should just like try and go back, I don't know. The Mirrodons are so hard to kill. These guys are not that bad. Although Chroma actually can't double this, so actually maybe they are bad. Maybe this one's bad. This one's not an issue. This one might be hard, because Chroma doesn't double. She doubles. I mean, she's also gonna be almost dead, so she can't actually make that attack next turn. Like, I have to spend next turn running away. Although that's, like, fine, right? Like, because Chrom, Robin can go this way. Cordelia can go that way, and they can't follow that. The question is, what's Chrom doing? But even Chrom... I'm just gonna have plus one movement, and he's gonna be standing here. Like, worst case, he can go here. And then this person's gonna be standing here, worst case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah, they can't reach that. What's Miriel doing this turn? Maybe I could pull this guy that way, but I don't want that. I'm not near wrestling this turn. Nothing relevant, presumably. Separate wouldn't be the most relevant thing to do. Okay, I'm gonna do this play. Level 20, right? Yeah. One and a half hours? No. Maybe. They're attacked for 27. Doesn't kill me. Maybe actually. Although this way I get to heal Cordelia, just maybe relevant. I mean, okay, well this way I end up with Sumia at full health and Cordelia at low health. As if the other player end up with both of them at low health. I mean, you being low health doesn't matter that much.
She just has damage. So this was, this I said was 15 damage. And this is 11 damage. It's the difference between 15 and 11. The guy has 33 health. How much stress would he have? I mean, say I deal 11 damage, he goes on 22. So in order to live a hit from him, he'd have to have 4 resistance. Let me check how much resistance I have. 5 resistance for the first attack. The Myrmidons have 4 resistance, so he would not live. Because he has 4 resistance, he goes down. Let me just check that they actually have 33 health. Yeah, 33 health, 4 resistance. So I deal 11 damage, he goes on 22, and then I have 26 to hit him, which kills. Okay. And he definitely doesn't die. To do this. No. Whew. He would never attack him. The other guy doesn't reach, so there's no point in using like a different sword. Speed. Damn it. He's behind on speed by a bit. Not by much, but for having leveled up, for having reset for levels in the early chapters, he is a little bit significantly behind. You're going this way or this way? Probably this way. Hmm. We're definitely going that way because you have to go that way. And I might go this way. I'll just stand here. Probably. Fast enough, yeah? Okay. This is exactly what we expected to happen, so it's good that it did. Okay, now it gets a bit weird. So what I accomplished last turn, and why we made that place, because I got rid of one of the counter people. Now there's only one other counter person left, which is you. Who is really hard to deal with, by the way, but... I mean... So now what I get to do is I get to take you... with... Cordelia, I guess. Which like hasn't accomplished that much either, but... Out of curiosity... There was a 14% crit chance and a 77% rune strike chance, okay. Just wanted to know that. But basically, I have to run away from this guy now. For a little bit. This is gonna be I've never played this chapter this way. This is gonna be interesting. Gonna have to do a little bit of kiting here, I think. Ideally, I'd like this guy to go after these people who can move. When everybody else chills in the corner. Unfortunately, he might not do that. He might, though. Go after Gregor, that would be bad. I can pick Gregor up here. Like 15. So the unfortunate part about that is that with two vulneraries, I don't take two hits. And you are still a massive problem. We'll go here. Let's take this guy. That's like a pretty reasonable play. To make sure that there's no shenanigans going on with the space being blocked, but there shouldn't be. What I can do is I can go here. Stop the Cordelia, take a potion. I go here and I trade with Sumia. I probably maybe even transfer back to get more Sumia points. And potentially like a dual strike. That'd be nice. And this guy should in some way follow me, either directly down or left. If he goes left, I just snipe him next turn, it's easy. If he goes down, I can kite them this way. Ideally, this guy goes there, but if he doesn't... Like, this guy is gonna go down, because he's gonna attack me. This guy's a little bit of a question mark. I think I'll try this play, though. Trade. No, over here. With you. Drink this. We drink this. You guys have to run away. I don't think I should be getting this spirit shot. We need to pair up over there. We have pass, right? Yeah, that's good. It's easier for me to see. Yeah, no, this is okay. I cannot run them for a while if I need to. Good. It's 5 XP. Okay, they're both going up. Okay, that's bad. I wish that one of them had gone down, but alright. What does life? Can I not kill you? Is that a thing? Holy shit, I'm fucking fast. Apparently also strong. So this is 11. Is this still 11? Nope. I can make this attack though. That works. From a different position, I guess, but from there. Okay, so I can take this guy isolatedly. For example, with Chrome. Can't double him, but... first of all, we're definitely doing this play. It's 13. This is 11, which kills. He has an advantage, so this is fine. I'll count on anything, that's the matter. I do not want Donald to dual strike here. Sweet. Get strength, come on. Come on, baby. Ah, damn it. Not speed and rest, it's fine. I guess. I just got HP. HP is definitely very relevant. So yeah, now... so, I can put Chrome here on this base. He would be... by himself? I don't know, I can... okay, so I could pair up Chrome with Miriel. And Kellam with Gaius, and Gaius can go here, and then Miriel can go here, switch to Chrome, and transfer. That way, he'd have plus defense. But I think that that's what I want. So, how much damage does my rapier do to this? So I lose one, so it goes down to 21, goes another one, goes down to 20, and then I get plus 10, so it goes to 30 versus 8, is 22 damage. However, if I equip this instead, then it's 24, 16. 16 plus 22 kills. So what I could do is I could make the killing edge attack first, see if I crit. If I crit, cool, sweet. If I don't crit, I can still kill him with the rapier the turn after that. I will need to be ready to kill shit next turn. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He's gonna be in range next turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They're gonna be somewhat in range. Well, as long as this guy doesn't go up. If he goes up... if he goes up, I can keep running, though. For one more turn. If he goes down... I just need to be able to be in range with the other people. Gaius is gonna be standing here. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it's fine. So yeah, I think I do this. This... okay, what do I even really gain? Okay, I should have just thought about this. I should do this first. Is it really worth to get the plus 5 defense? Like, it saves me 2 damage. So, the damage goes from 31 versus 8 is 23. to 21. Not that it really matters. But now that I've like done this garbage that I just did, I kinda have to do this now. It was a misplay though. Like, I need to have Miriel free by herself, which means I have to do something like this now. It wasn't necessary to bother doing this in the first place, though. Apparently miscounted damage. Oh wait, because I didn't consider the plus 3 damage strength, these things are good. So it must be actually somewhat relevant for that, I suppose. Okay, so ideally I'd like to get one of these kills with Sumia and the other one with Cordelia. It might be slightly hard to do. You okay with this? Nope. That might be slightly hard to do. So I could do this to put him to 1. That's cool. That gives me the kill to Sumia. Probably be doing this one instead. Maybe. Maybe not. I'll have to see. However, I'm not sure that leaves me with an ability to kill this guy. I mean, well. Ability there is. Ability there is, yes, good. What I can do then is I could move here, I could transfer, switch. Attack this guy with Robin and finish him with Chrome. That'd be okay. We hit for 18 or 21 if you really want. Just 14 or 17. They need to deal 16 damage after, even in the best case. It just does. Do 16 damage, okay. It's interesting. So what I can do is I can do this. And half the time, well, no. About 75% of the time I kill. Actually, crit doesn't kill, so it's a little bit less. A little bit less than 75% of the time I kill. If I don't kill, I just make this attack and it's fine. Like, oh, I have to hit this? Shit, never mind. Maybe it's not fine. I could risk that though. Nobody wanted that. Okay, what's my backup? Okay, so let's say I miss this. I mean, well, that's not backup. If he misses, I'm dead. 9. Well, I can. Okay, no. I can hit. If I get the Robin dual strike, I just kill. If I hit both and none of them are drop and dual strike, then I still have to F. I mean, well, this is not much better, but this is 80. Can I. Okay, no, I can make the attack from here, though. I make the attack from here. Yeah, this is better. Make the attack from here. And that way you. Have 1, 2, 4 points. You get an extra 10. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna do this. And then you. But I can't actually. Doesn't actually work because I don't actually get to move. I don't actually get to make the attack with Miriel because I would need to be on Chrome space. So Chrome would have to attack from here instead. But then. I can't. No, I can't attack from here. Okay, so I can attack from here. attack from here. If I don't get the kill, Chrom moves here and gets this kill. Then she moves up. Attacks with the Elwind. The Elwind does 21 versus 4, 17 damage. And then this is gonna do the other 16 damage. Okay. In the ideal case, we just get the dual strike here though. Make sure he has the white weapon equipped. Yeah. Please just get dual strike. Sweet, thank you. Okay, so now let me check that just one more time. 17, perfect. So you can, like, move away now. I want you to be in range so that I get the extra hit chance, so I'm just gonna put you here, I guess. You here? Sure. It doesn't matter. It's too either way. Sweet. Just a little bit of XP for guys. Just cool. And I can now also get to use the Iron Lance instead. Sent here, I guess. I don't think they have support anyway, but. There we go. Okay, we beat the hard part of the chapter. And we just have to beat the easy part. I have to figure out now how many vulneraries I'm willing to use on healing people up now. But that's interesting. Should we have Pep healed up before I did that? It's a rescue. This is the master seal. This one's the second seal. Okay, I have to think about when I'm supposed to second seal Chrom. Cause if I want to second seal him now, I should do this group first. Well, I mean, I'm not gonna use Chrom for this Chrom probably, though. So maybe I should not. I should have thought about this before I started doing the chapter. I always make this like mistake, if you want to call it that. Chrom is very far from his stat caps right now. However, I'm actually going to use Chrom as like a real unit for late game purposes. And for late game purposes, there's actually some merit to second sealing early. Of the weird way that the XP works. But like, that's like for like really late game, like it's like very late game when that starts being a thing. So like the thing is like this, basically the way it works, from what the effect ends up being, not internally I mean, is if I second seal now, I get stronger by a lot I stay about the same vibe when I do it, and then I pull ahead in how strong I am because I get more experience. And then we could be comparing it to what would happen if I were to second seal at like level 20-ish. So for a while I'm ahead. And then at some point the second seal at level 20 happens. I'm still the early second seal is still ahead, and then the late second seal starts creeping up, and then at some point it overtakes it. And for a while it stays ahead. good, like it pulls a little bit further ahead, and then that stays at some point and starts staying around equal. And then it's the early second seal starts going slightly ahead again. But that's like really, really late when that happens. Because the way it works is that when you second seal, you get, like, with a second seal now, I don't know if it rounds down or up, but, I would be essentially considered level 6 XP wise, and then I would go up to stretch level 20, then I would master seal. But the other thing is, okay, so it also depends on whether you go to 20 or you go to, like, whether you go to, like, going to 10 then going to 20 is a lot strong, is a lot better for XP game late game than going to 20 and then going to 10. But even if you go to 20 and then 20, you have to, you have like, you basically, once you have 10 levels worth extra of stats. Assuming you didn't set cap before. And then you master seal, and then from now on, like forever, basically you're 5 levels ahead in XP. Which is obviously better than, I mean, you have 10 levels ahead in stats versus 5 levels ahead in XP, which is an advantage level wise. But first of all, it's gonna mean you are a lot slower to get to your skills, which for Chrome isn't, I mean, for Chrome it matters for Defender, but Defender it's balanced out by just having more stats. And Aegis isn't super important. For Chrome, going 20-20... I mean, well, you also did 10 more levels up with level ups, I guess. Like, you, this is hard to describe. You have going 20-20 versus going 10-20. You get 10 more level ups early, which in like the really long game don't end up really being much XP, so for then again it's better again. I think for long game purposes, for long game purposes, I should be keeping Chrome as a lord for now. That said, getting him early is good for the early game. The problem technically getting him is better for the early game. Cavalier is a stronger class, has movement, can use lances. I want to get the discipline, I want to get the lance level early, I don't want to be stuck on bronze lances for too long. This is always like a really hard decision when to second seal. Let me quickly check this max stats. Because I do have to like make sure he's not stat capping when I, like, if I go too late and then I second seal and then he stat caps, and it's like, oops, can't have that happen. Yeah, I think actually considering stat caps and considering that I want to go to 20 before I really master seal him, I should do it now. I mean, well, as soon as I have the second seal. Which favors doing this side first. In case I want to use Chrome for this side. I mean, I can figure out how to do this side first. Do this side first. And, like, if it doesn't use Chrome. Which it usually doesn't. And then I do this side. This side is definitely always still scary. Although... I think last time what I did is I attacked from here. This way to pull them in a way that was favorable for me. Somehow. I wanna check what I did last time when I get there. But for now, let's figure out how to do the left part. It's based on, like, who I heal, who I give vulneraries to, I should say. Depends on how I want to approach this. So again, I would like to get XP on Sumia and Cordelia, but it's a bit hard against these enemies, because, like... I mean... yeah. What? If I remember correctly, this guy doesn't attack when you stand here. Pretty sure he doesn't. Pretty sure he doesn't. So how strong is Miriel? Twenty. So she can one-shot that if she wants, and... I'd like to finish him off with, like, Sumia or... Cordelia, ideally, but the issue is they use lances, and that's not good. What's your guys' hit rate? I know there are ways I can increase my hit rate a little bit, but I just want to gauge a little bit. You can't fly over this? That's... you can fly... that's... it's really weird that you can't fly over this. Because you can... you can fly over the one... the village in chapter... in parallel 2. I'm pretty confident. I mean, okay, this is 90 base, so if I can just get it plus 2 a little bit more... like, okay, no. If Miriel's standing here, she has B with him, so she has... oh no, but she needs 5. So ideally, like, Miriel stands here, she kills this from here, and then I would need... well, no. Or, like, from here, right? Miriel stands here, I would attack from here, and somebody stands here. And it's 100% to hit. And I just need to figure out how to kill you while I'm doing that. That's a little bit tricky. You never live a... damn it. You never live it, even at full health, right? You do actually, wow. Okay, that's impressive. So, like, if a strength support, I can even one shot. I just need to make sure that she doesn't get crit. Which is pretty hard to do. It's actually quite hard to do. Wait, this guy is, well, this guy is Luna. At plus 4 damage, it does kill me. Okay. So you would need strength and resistance, but I can't give you both. In order to avoid the crit, I could send, like, if Sumia's, like, from here, I could attack from here. That avoids the crit. First of all, though, it doesn't kill. Second of all, I also need resistance support, and I think my only resistance support that I have is, this is plus one. But the only real resistance support I have is Sumia, who was busy killing this. This is fine. Okay, so, no, it's not. Fucking anathema. So you don't need Robin support for doing this. No, you do. You absolutely do. Because otherwise you don't have arms on it, right? Shit. Although you can... could do this. Like, okay, how much damage do you do? It's a normal wind. 18... 17... 34... So you need to do 5. Okay, what I can just do, I can just give her some strength support. And make that attack, and then I get to have two chances to hit. And if I don't hit, I just finish it off with somebody else. Like, oh well. And then I can put Robin to just stand. Oh fuck, this guy's passed. Never mind. I don't want to risk the crit. Although I can't, it's just like don't live, right? Because I don't have rest support, right? How strong are you? No. So you deal 22. That's not. I can't give you that much strength support. Fortunately. So what if I just attack him with Crown first? Can I just do that? My Crown doesn't get crit. So what if I just deal 25 to you? I deal 25 to you, but that deals 19, it's on to 17. Because I just have a strength, you just need some strength support, right? Well, you already do, shit, no matter. You can get... Do you have support of what? Do. You can get two more, 27. 27 deals... 21. 15 left, that would work. Let's make sure that that's actually the right number. These people away from him. Wait, but if, I mean, okay, anybody can finish this, so that would be Chrome, right? And guys can finish it too. Okay, so now you're 27. Just 21 and 15 negatives. So, all I really need is to make sure that I have a backup attack in case Sumia misses. Which is. Wait, no. She can't miss, right? Because. No, she can't miss. I'm doing it the other way. What I need to be able to do is I need to get Chrom to be able to attack this, though, which I currently can't. this is actually bad. Shit. I don't get to do that and also... Chrome can't detect this issue. Wait, what damage YouTube? Damn it. How do I do damage to you then? Chrome can't reach. Can you. Do we have a way to not kill? No, there's no way. 26. 20, yeah. There should be a way I can get both of these killed with the right people. We'll figure out how. Ba 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 da 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 How about you? Doesn't reach either. It's annoying that it's so hard to reach. I sort of feel like all of my people who can walk through the desert are a little bit tied up. I like the Chrome idea, but I just don't see a way to get Chrome in. Like, even if I change the way I position, I don't necessarily need to have Sumia paired up with Robin for this. But even if I have Robin free, Robin doesn't carry Chrome over there, and Robin kills this guy. I don't know, maybe I just don't get to get this kill on Cordelia. Yeah. What luck do you have? 14, good. So he has 0% good chance on you, in case that matters. Also, this is bone, so maybe we can't attack from here. Okay, what I could do... No, okay. Good talk. No, I totally... No, I couldn't. Could I? No. Because I can't get rid of the chance to get crit. Although, do I have more luck? Okay, you also, I can also pair up with Robin for that, to get rid of the crit chance. I can stand here, and he should attack. That should be, like, that should be close enough to attack. That way I get to lure them out, and I can just take them like that. I literally just put a flyer here, everybody else still way in the back. I just put like Sumia here with a javelin equipped. And shouldn't die to this. Maybe? Well, Sumia with Cordelia in the back. Well, all the way around just won my health, but this is step both 4, plus 2 and I raise the 4 here. But let's see, this is plus 3 or plus 4? Plus 3. So you would have 15 res, goes down to 8 res. So 31 effective HP. This is plus 12, so it's 31, so I die exactly. Other way around, you would have 11 res, goes down to 6 res, so 32 effective HP. So she would live on 1. I could have Cordelia and Sumia just here, pass the turn. This guy would. Although, no, fuck, no, I can't. Now I don't have enough luck again. Damn it. I could do it if I kill these guys first, actually, because then I could put Robin here. Maybe that's the plan. Maybe I do these guys first. Doing these guys first tends to be better, because like this side tends to be easier, and then I get like typically like maybe a level up, and the next might make this side easier. Like maybe I would get a level up in Cordelia if I did this side first, and then maybe level up Cordelia makes the side easier. Who knows? I really would like to get both of these girls and Sumia Cordelia. Okay, let's see how do I... Okay, let me check my video from my last playthrough to see how I did that there. Because I feel like I used, like, a pretty specific strat. And I did something... I think I attacked the X guy from the right, from the left, from the water. Yeah, it definitely looks like that. Yeah, I did. Yeah, then I took the mages with Robin. So we had to go do something. And the music playlist just happened to run out at that time. Where's the other one? Let's actually just listen to this one. Shouldn't be, the shadow shouldn't be that much longer. See what these guys have. This guy has counter like always. Silver Sword. Okay, so I can take this guy. With somebody, presumably like Cordelia or something. So, in that case, I would be using Sumia to make this attack. Okay, one of these guys has Aegis, unfortunately. But I can take these two with Robin. I'm not taking you. I'm attacking you to start the fight. It's a little bit dicey, isn't it? I can alternatively... doesn't work that well. I can actually double, I can double this guy with Robin. I just realized, because I have Sumia, I'm like insanely fast. If I can double this guy with Robin, go here. These guys I also take with Robin. This guy, oh wait, this guy can reach me, never mind. Although, Miriel can one-shot this guy. It's not good for XP to do that though. All the XP goes to Robin. I'll not do that, I'll do your plan where I am. Sumia can attack this. Oh, Sumia or Cordelia, probably Sumia. Cordelia can take this. I guess. Well, yeah, would need Donald support, otherwise she gets doubled. I should deal 16 damage. Fortunately, 16 plus 16 isn't 33. This guy would be dead, this guy would be on like 16 health. They're seeing Krom can kill from there, right? Krom can deal 22, yeah, for sure. Really? Can almost kill from there. So that would mean, okay, that would probably mean I do advantage. Shit, you look, okay, nevermind. The case, that doesn't actually work. Because he heals. What if I attack with a stronger weapon? Like if I attack with a thunder that hits for 28. So 22 down to 14. I mean, I have to like back up. It's kinda bad to do that though. You're so fucking fast. It's gonna having Aegis. Not very nice right now. How much does 17? I figured that already. So, but the issue is that this guy is gonna bait me. I could learn over there. Bring somebody there. And then, like, he's standing here, and then he's like a little bit to get driven up kind of the rest. You could do that, it's okay. So what I did was this, so... this guy takes 16. And he has advantage. It doesn't work so well. But like... so... this plus this with an Alban and a Sea Lance is just enough to kill this. With 16 plus 17. But... I mean, if I take this, then I have to make the Miriel attack, and I can't also make the Miriel attack to set up this kill. I could... okay, if I lure this guy away with somebody who can run... so we would also be here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I might go here though. So let's say Miriel kills this. Let's say I can bait this guy to go over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, well, this guy being over there would mean that Sumia can't really do anything here. Sumia would be out of the encounter until this guy. I mean. You'll be able to finish off this guy afterwards, but not until then. So let's say Robin finishes off that guy, because he's the only one who really reliably can. Out of the vantage. So he heals first. Then... so I don't get to melee attack this guy. Like, I could make the Cordelia... I could make a Cordelia javelin attack against them. Hope I hit. Deal 9? That's not great. Then I need to deal another 24. You have to attack for 29, which you can. That's cool. A lot of strength. So that way, I would kill everybody. The kills would go to Robin, Chrom, Miriel, which is not great. And then I can hopefully set up this kill afterwards for, I definitely set up this kill afterwards for Sumia, so that's good. So that's Sumia, Miriel, Chrom, Robin. It's not so bad, especially since... Cordelia also gets 2 assists, so I think that's okay. I'm gonna go with that. So you don't actually need health for this, Chrom. Wait, didn't I say... is the Chrom XP gonna be wasted? Because I have to second seal him? Now? It is, right? It is. So then that's annoying. I'd rather get this kill with somebody else then. Also, who was gonna be taking that hit and not die? Oh, 33 is a big number. She can do that? Okay. 8 luck. This is 7 crit. Sure. Actually, setting up his kills are gonna be a little bit harder than I thought it was, because I deal damage to him. So the wind from her actually kills, instead of not killing. Although this attack deals... 24, 23... alright, that's okay. It's gonna be fine. So... he's gonna be... maybe here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That doesn't reach. Really? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. With 8 it reaches. But I don't probably don't do enough damage, right? I get Sumia Javelin with plus 4 strength, which doesn't do enough damage. 16, yeah, just doesn't drop down. 16, that's still 11. Is that not enough with the. Together with the Cordelia Javelin? The issue is I wanna second seal Chrome right now. So I don't want him hitting. I don't wanna, like, just get him to, like, 50, and then he starts hitting strength caps and defense caps, and it's like, oh. And if I'm doing it soon, then I should, like, do it. Like, I should do it before the start of the next chapter. And so it's like, if I get this kill on him, I just kind of waste the XP. Like, right now he's at 33 XP, it's like a pretty good position to. I can seal him, so I would rather get this kill on somebody else. Oh, it's just wasted. But I don't see how I would get it on anybody else. So what if... Okay, hold up. First of all, what I should really do is I should really give Sumia Steel Lance. Although sometimes Cordelia misses this guy, by the way. Something I should keep in mind. Not very often, but it does happen. Where's that? Oh, does he have that? Right. How strong are you with this? 19, you'd have another plus 3 if you gave you that support, so 22. I mean, 22 is still only 17 damage. So it's still need a 16 damage setup, which. Her javelin certainly doesn't do. Also, that, like, misses a lot of the time, so I'm not gonna go for that anyway. Although, actually, misses very badly. No. Wait, no, it doesn't, because then Void Extract shit. I just don't want to give him to Chrome, it's so wasted. But, like, Robin's busy dealing with these guys. I can't really give it to Sumia in any way I see. Unless I can maybe do more attacks on this guy sometimes. I can probably just, like, put more attacks on them, and then see if I get it, and then if I don't, I just do it with Chrome. It's like, would be a waste, but like, it's fine, I guess. How much hit was this? 96? That's pretty okay. Not clear that I actually want to pair her up at all. Or maybe I just, like, wanna have. Assuming that these two guys are gonna be standing next to each other, which actually they might not, right? I'm just gonna just go here. Well, they might though. Again, the boss guys is such as I have to get the kill with Chrome, and it's like fine. If I do stand next to each other, then I can maybe, like, grab. Oh wait, no, I'm making the I'm already using the javelin on this guy anyway, so it, position doesn't look good. Definitely you can make an attack against him and see if you hit. And if he, if she does, then Sumia's attack kills, right? Even without burst, without pit up. Appears to be back. Anyway, if she hits, then I can finish off with Sumia. I'm gonna say both. As long as everybody hits, it's fine. Just check how much damage this does. Not like I take chances on shit. It's okay. I want to see that. So, you don't actually need health, do you? These guys don't have Luna. Yeah. Oh, wait. He does if we don't give him rest support. Shit, okay. Oh, that's 4 plus 5, yeah. I don't really get to give him rest support with what I'm doing, so I'm just gonna use one area, I guess. This guy having 10 extra dodge is annoying. Could definitely lose to this guy. 35 avoid is hard to overcome. There's probably a way to set up for it that's guaranteed, but I'll have to find it. It's not clear that I will. Let me like, where's Miriel? I'm just gonna go in and get attacked by these. She steps in here. Got attacked by this. You have to be able to reach this to kill him. You wanna be able to kill this, or attack this rather. So right now, 26 hits for 21. So you need strength support then. Well, this needs to be available. Isn't enough, right? 3, 29, 44. Oh, that's okay, that's good. So you go here. You want to be in a position where you get to attack that person. So if you send here, then I can do that easily. You might want to be in a position. I don't know, a lot of people just want to be in positions where they can trade around weapons and shit. Okay. So we start with this. I would like to miss one of those, but it's fine. It's like a very minor deal. So again, 8 luck versus 7 crit, 33 damage versus 35 effective health, there's no Luna. Counter doesn't matter because I'm not counter attacking. That is okay. Yeah. Oh, I should have checked that this isn't okay. I should pay more attention to that. I mean, I know that I can take this guy from like his general experience, but I still should have checked that again. Any specific position I want to go to? Probably just that one. I want this guy to not be... I mean, since 3 spaces of her, I guess. Yeah, I definitely don't. Okay, so... this space is within 3 spaces, but this space isn't. However, I also need to not force them to melee me. But like, if I go here, and this guy moves first, and this guy is going to melee me, because there's space issues, and then I will die. So that is something I have to prevent more, in a sense. Should have paid attention to this anathema though, that was bad. I could have moved over here. I could have done that side. So that was a big mistake. I should have paid attention to this anathema. It's gonna reduce her crit avoid. Which means that this guy might have a 9% crit chance against her. Which is just, I mean, it's gonna be, well, 7%, I guess. Well, I can put the person here and here, and then it's gonna be fine. Yeah, it's fine. I just literally put you here. And you there. Good now. And then it's suddenly all totally fine. And then I go all the way here to make sure that they always have avenues to attack me from range. Although I don't know. If I go here, this guy attacks first and doesn't kill. This guy should attack first though? No, this guy should attack first. I'm not sure. If I attack here, this way is shorter than going like this. So does this guy actually have a chance to melee attack me if I go here? So I'll just go here. That way, no matter which order they attack in, they always have... yeah, okay. I'll probably put Chrome here, and you over here. That gives you enough range to walk to everybody. I want Chrome next to Robin. I don't want Chrome to be too far. I mean, I guess, I don't know, it's just even further. Depends on where you go. If he goes here... 1, 2, 3. I mean, no, it's fine. Let's do this. How much damage do you do? Well, you did 20. So I need to do another 16. So I need to hit for 22 base. Just works for, okay. Then I guess I just like move here and... yeah, yeah. And now we find out how we fucked up and accidentally died. Not this way. Cool. Now he's open to make some attacks, which is very good for XP things. Definitely be able to get a kill with Sumia this way. And maybe even with Cordelia, depending on how it goes. Okay, so what's really important is that I stay out of range of this guy. This guy's vantage, yeah. I guess I'll try this maybe. Like maybe this. No, I'm not gonna make the range attack for that. So unless I put somebody here with Frederick. Would give me plus 4 strength. Which would deal 10. So I still have to make this attack though, which is kinda shitty. I would have thought a bit more about her ability to run away. So it's all about XP right now. Did I think about? So like in the ideal case, I get one kill with her. And one other kill with her. It's gonna be pretty hard to set that up. So I can start by doing this, and if I... Well, that's actually like a really good start. Then I can try doing this. With a little bit more hit rate. So let's see if we hit this. That's very good. So, I get to put somebody here to make that hit rate higher. I just have to make sure that I have a backup attack at the end. Then I would like to get this kill, so I need to do 17. Well, ideally I'd like to do 20. Which I can do by just doing this. Like this. And equip Miriel. And I will risk this. So let's compute the chance that we die here before we make this attack. So 96 displayed hit rate is 99.72% active hit rate. So the chance that we miss is 0.28%. And then the chance that he hits is 0.028 times 0.6 hit rate, 65. Which is in actuality 75.85. Then he has to wait at the 0.17. Good. So the chance that I die here is 0.00036 if I make this attack. We might not have to do that, do we? No, we do, because you have no support. And I can't give you more skill, I can't give you more hit rate with support. Definitely, I can give you more hit rate. Tom's already in range. Alright, don't miss. Or don't get crit then, if you miss. Okay. Give me speed and strength. Yes, yes, let's fucking go. So now I just need to put, somebody over there. I can always have this attack as a backup. It's perfect. Not do it with you, because, well, let's just like start building this, so I know that I've done this. Let's try and hit this. I guess I should also, this. Next time we deal with this guy. How much damage do you do? 17, yeah. But only if I only hit one of those giant attacks, I could set that up better, but it's gonna be fine. 21, 20. Can make some other giant attacks, it's gonna be fine. Like, worst case, I don't get the all the experience on her. Just like, pretty. Pretty mild worst case scenario. Okay, so how much damage do you do again? Okay. Yeah, nothing here. No, no, no. So this would be 15 damage. Even 18. What's this? I can start with this and see what happens. With like dual strikes and shit. Okay. Okay, your farm wasn't that good, right? Yes. Sweet. Strength, 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 strength. Yes, let's fucking go. Also got level. Strength on her is so incredibly important that like a no HP, no death, no speed level up is still good. I get to think about whether I can. How much healing items I have. Not really. Okay, first of all, before I forget it. Everybody's fine, right? Yeah. I'm gonna actually have to buy a bronze lens, because I don't think I have any bronze lenses left. Slightly mistimed how long the trip is gonna take, so I know I have to start different music again. Okay, so now we get to do the thing I mentioned earlier, where This is all bones. I'm fucking dumb. I can't stand here. Oh my gosh. Well, there goes that plan. Oops. I'm fucking dumb, okay. My plan was to go here and have him, have Robin stand here so that Gorilla doesn't get crit, but that isn't happening. Basically, I can't engage this without getting crit, right? Well, from like further away. Like, obviously, if I engage from here and Robin stands here, and this works, but. But if I do that, I have to kill. And I can only. I can only actually live the attack if you guys are paired up, which doesn't give you any strength. In which case, I only deal 30 damage. 30 is not quite enough. My enemy has that much health. And also, like, also the problems with that as well. Obviously, I can just walk in with Robin and kill. The question is, how do I get these two kills on these two girls? Like, I have a way to kill, to walk in here with Miriel, almost kill this, but not quite kill this, and then I have a guaranteed kill on this with Sumia. That is something I can do. But then the issue is, how do I kill this? I can't reach them. And because this guy, like, I can barely get my flyers, one of my flyers, to survive Arquint. But because he has an Athema, I can't avoid the chance to get crit. I would need plus 3 luck. Which just doesn't give me. I'm using plus 1 luck. Oh yeah. Get rid of these. I wonder how much a kill on Cordelia is worth over, like, a kill on Robin.
Ugh.
I don't know. I just don't see a way to get one with both of them. I don't see how I would bait them out. Like, I should just be super careful around this guy with his Luna and Athema garbage. Garbage. yeah. It's actually kinda scary regardless. Like, I mean, obviously, if I want to use two Vulneraries, I can just kill him with Robin. But this guy, like, if I pair up with Sumia, then this guy actually, if he crits. Actually, he doesn't have a chance to crit, even with through Anathema. 14 luck is enough to never get crit. Now, wait, do I have a Bronze Lance or not? I don't think so. I can at least get the XP to Chrom, I think. In some way, probably. So Miriel walks here, attacks. This bones, right? Shit, no what. Miriel attacks still. You try and get this kill. But you have to range attack, right? Need a backup plan in case I miss it still then. This is like a lot harder than usual for some reason. Even though like they don't even have Aegis or Pervies, and it's still like really hard to get these kills with the right people. Let me just to make sure. I mean, like, just to make sure they're not being like complete retard right now. Going here will not trigger them. I just want to make sure that that's true. I should make back up though, not move forward. I just want to make sure. I'm like quite confident that they don't get triggered by that, but. Yeah, okay. I mean, I could also just like stand there with Robin and like a lot of health, maybe. Like, if I healed Robin up, like this guy deals 0. Well, I know he doesn't deal 0. He deals 19 versus 10. It's 9. And this guy deals. Well, I wouldn't have defense support then. Okay, do that. That way I get to lure them into better positions. So now this guy deals 19 versus 7, which is 12. And then this guy deals 33 versus 15, is 18, so I take 13. So I would have to use two vulneraries, which is pretty expensive. I would stand here, this guy will attack from here, and the mage will attack from here or here. And then how do I actually do it? Like, wait, no, what am I saying? Mage will attack from here. So then, like, say Sumia attacks from here. Sumia kills from here. How am I actually gonna attack this then? Chrom? I mean, like, I guess Chrom can get the kill. Just pair up Chrom with some speed support, like this. Well, no, I can't. I mean, I'd have to heal Chrom as well then. That's so. Ugh. Well, no, if I don't. Okay. I don't have to pair up Chrom. I'd have to. I would pair up with the Sphinx support, I suppose. I would do this, attack for 27. Choose 19. No, it's 21. I have to do 15, which she does deal. That should work. It's just, I need so many vulneraries for that. I need so many vulneraries for that. Like, I need to get you over 30, which means two vulneraries for you. How do I need to get you? I need to live a 19. Can I give you res? Does this give res? Probably not. It does. Okay, hold up. But now I don't deal enough damage to the mage anymore. Now I have two res effectively, so now I take 17. Then would bend one vulnerary would be enough for that. But now he only deals. Wait, I can take out the steel sword. Then it does deal enough damage. New 7, yeah. So basically, I'm using 3 vulneraries. And my result is I get kills on both of these. Whereas, if I didn't use any vulneraries, what could I do? I mean, if I. Like, the easiest way is I could just move Robin here, kill this, and then this guy dies to Robin as well. I could even. Maybe there's a mid ground. I could also kill Robin here, and somebody who has health, like you. Can take away Robin's weapons. He gets attacked. And then I have to figure out a way without healing at all to get a kill on Sumia. What damage did you do? 18, 12, 24. But then I can just do the attack with her. Give her a little bit of luck. I mean, I'm gonna get the luck, but I can just... I need a little bit of luck. Just give luck, does it? No. It only gives 2 luck, but I guess that would be fine. I can just, like, attack here. I don't even have to take a bit of weapon, really. I can just stand there with, I'm gonna stand there with Frederick. Frederick will always get attacked. And then, I will be standing here. The mage will be standing here. Well, no, he'll be standing here because he's attacking Frederick. I can even put Frederick, like, here. Yeah, then he goes, like, all the way out. He doesn't die to overhead, because he has, he likes 12, right? Because he has enough luck to not get crit. So it's versus 7, yeah, it's just, he just takes 12, so he doesn't die. So I would go here. Then I just attack with, like, if Miriel Donnell. I attack this guy, I deal 24 damage. Then I just need Sumia to be able to deal 24. How much avoid do you have? 17. Yeah, no, this easily kills. Okay. So this works. So this way I get one kill on Robin instead of a kill on Cordelia, but I save 3 vulneraries with that play. That's the reverse, right? Like, I say 300 gold for the cost of a kill on him rather than her. I mean, I still want kill, like, I still want XP on Robin. Not like I don't want XP on Robin. I just want less on him than I want on other people. Three people next to him. They even have support. He even has support with them, so it's like even more than 3 points. But just to make sure, like, just to make sure he doesn't get crit. Should maybe not be clobbering up this much. That's super slow, yeah. Okay. So now... There's a chance that I crit, but I mean, whatever. I guess that happens. What happens, I guess. I guess when I did my calculations for how many things it would cost me, I didn't actually consider the fact that I still have to kill the boss, and maybe some of the amount of the stuff I need for doing this would have helped me toward the boss, but it seems pretty unlikely anyway. Okay, now how do we kill the boss? I mean, we definitely get him low with Robin, so I don't use too many vulneraries. So I have to count damage a little bit. So I take 7. And I deal back 13 twice, 26. 26 is a bit of a weird number to put him at. I was like, that puts him to 17. And she can't really deal 25. What damage would you do in a return attack? 16, 8. Wait, 8, 8's perfect, right? Because I, like, I deal 26. And then I deal another 16. That would put into 1. And if I just get 1 dual strike, then... Oh wait, you have... You have Favis, that's a bit annoying. How damage do you do? I want to get this kill with Sumia, that's important. How much Void do you have, I guess? Me too. It's a bit annoying. So ideally I'd get you down to 4. Which damage do you do? 5, 10? So that's too much if I get 1 dual strike. But it's not enough if I don't get any dual strikes. Oh, also I have to consider he has Nosferatu, so... That's a bit annoying. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna... I wanna see how this dual strikes run up, turn out. I'm gonna take crit, but I guess that's just gonna be how it's gonna be. Doesn't that Luna anything? Can't crit. Yeah. It's always scary to do this for some reason. Even though that's like nothing actually scary about it. Okay, I got 1. So now... Damn it, that light up sucked. I'm so low on magic. And magic is so bad. So you have... Pavis and Kona. So I can't actually... I'm not gonna be able to deal rage for 18. You get you out of here first. This guy doesn't, like, heal or anything, so... So if I were to heal you... What would happen is... Well, it depends on if he hits me or not. If he were to hit me, he would heal... Say I heal Miriel. He heals for 8, up to 17, and then I deal 10, down to 7. Can I get you to deal 14 damage? Yeah, probably. Yeah, definitely. So worst case would be that she gets the kill. Best case that she gets the kill, but Maybe I can have a more secure way to give her the kill. Be a little bit hard, maybe. 1, 8. Heals 4, 8. That's not good. Not this one. It's the ideal 14. Okay, yeah, no, this is good. Like, worst case, got a leg and secure, that's pretty good worst case. If he hits me, he heals 4, 9. Goes up to 18, I heal 14 back. That's great. No, actually, fuck, I don't though, because I actually only deal. Shit, only. Fuck. I only deal 6 damage here, because. Police, come down. So, like, if he hits me, then he heals for 9, I deal 6, then. He's at more health than he was before. What if I gave you resistance? I'll do it with Sumia. So you hit me for. So you heal 6 and I deal 13 damage back. Effectively, that's 7. That one's good. This one also never kills. No. This one also never kills me. Yeah. I mean, I never kill it. He never kills me. This is good. Perfect. And now. Oh, pair up with somebody better. Well, actually, just upgrade Chromie. Yeah, now this is guaranteed, doesn't advantage. I deal 5, I kill, I get the thing. Everything's perfect. Sweet. GG. It was a long ass attempt for what an easy chapter this is. Oh, and I got a really good last level up. Sweet. My Rob level up sucked. The most other level ups are pretty okay. Pretty good. Higher side. Sweet. Let's fucking go.